up with some stuff, and then all of a sudden it'd be like, oh, my very tasteful tastemaker friends in the industry feel like this ain't good enough. This ain't good enough. And to me, as a black woman, I felt like my art was being attacked. Like, it was like, oh, you're too ghetto. This is too urban. Like, I can't do that because I'm in a space in my career where I can't do that. I can't do that. And then we got to the place where we're about to do the cover. When we're about to do the cover, it just felt like my artistic capabilities were being compromised. You feel me? It was like, I don't want to do nothing you want to do. You got to do it my way. You got to do it this way. And I did it. You know what I'm saying? Because I'm like, all right, this my sis. We doing the project, whatever. I'm going to just do the cover the way she want me to do the cover. When I did the cover, it came out. I'm like, yo, I'm not rocking with this or whatever. And I just felt like, you know, me and my team's side isn't being respected or being heard. And they were just like, it just seems like you guys are being problematic. But it wasn't like we were being problematic. The issue was that we just wanted us to have an equal voice in the project if we're doing a project together. You feel me? It's like, why is it that you feel like you're more superior than me and that my opinion doesn't matter if we're doing this as sisters? That's how I started feeling. And then moral of the story, I told her when we got on the phone, I'm like, yo, if you don't want to respect me, we ain't got to do this project. If you can't respect me and my team, we ain't got to do the project. That's why the project didn't come out, because of the cover differences. It kept getting crazy. When it came down to the music, she's extremely talented. I fuck with her as an artist. Her artistry is phenomenal. We did great music together. The music is fucking fire. The music was out of here. Like, if that project came out, I feel like it would have did good for both of us. But I felt like I wasn't going to compromise myself and my own respect and dignity to put out a project with somebody. That would have been me using her. You feel me? That would have been me clout chasing. Me clout chasing would have been me just bowing down and being like, all right, I'm going to just use this cover and let it come out. So I didn't do that. So next thing happened was, she started hyping up one of the records from the project. Like, y'all want this, y'all want this. It was a record with me, her, and Keisha Cole. And I started getting offended because I felt like, yo, if we're not doing the project, then none of the music should come out. Because that's how talented I am. I feel like if I'm talented enough to go record some new music and not use any of that music, that's how I felt. I was okay with not ever putting any of that music out. I'm like, none of this music has to ever come out. If we're not doing the project, I can walk away from it and stand on that as an artist. So she decides that she's going to put out the record, and she takes me off and leaves Keisha. The problem was that made us fall out was I felt like it should have never came out. And that's what our beef stems from, was her putting out all me. I never wanted all me to come out, and she wanted all me to come out regardless. And that's the real tea. I've never used her. I've never used anybody. If I used her, I would have put out the version with me on it. I would have tried to use that for streams. I never did that. I never even addressed this. You feel me? It was our song. We did a project together. We recorded that in the studio together in the 400 studio in Las Vegas. So all of this that I'm upset and I'm trying to use her, what did I use you for? What did I get out of our friendship? If anything, I was genuine. I loved you. I still considered you a sister. My problem came from the disrespect. It started getting out of hand. It was on some, oh, you're black, you're ghetto, you're not tasteful. Like, this is not good. This is not good. I don't like this. So I'm like, all right, whatever. It don't ever have to come out. Now we at where we at with it. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, I apologize. I'm a woman. Like, you know, I shouldn't have threatened her or whatever. But rightfully so, you know, when you're upset and you're angry, things come out the wrong way. That's the thing that comes out. But that's why I was upset about it, because I felt like all me shouldn't have came out if we not doing the project. I never released none of the music. She said, fuck it, and then put the music out. So all this stuff that's on the blogs about me, running up budgets and all this extra stuff and trying to use her for streams and things of that nature. How did I use you for streams if I never put out the other version of All Me With Me on it? It's not like I don't have that version. I have the version of that record. I chose not to do that specifically because I didn't want people thinking I was clout chasing. The only reason things got addressed on my live yesterday is because people kept asking me, why aren't you guys doing the music? Why are you guys doing the music? And that's what happened. It kept being a situation where I felt like I wasn't good enough. And that's just that. So I'm not going to address it again. Y'all can take it how y'all want it. I've never been a problematic person. I respect everybody. My name ain't never been caught up in the blogs on no messy stuff. Even when I left my label, I just left. I left it at that. I never disrespected YG either. This is other people saying that I'm clout chasing. She was making me seem like, oh, I'm too good for that. For my brand, for where I'm at in my career, I can't do that. That's what it was feeling like. So don't let motherfuckers make y'all feel like, oh, Kamyiah not genuine, Kamyiah not real. Kamyiah always been real. Kamyiah always kept it 100. And that's just the facts. I ain't never been the type of motherfucker that be on social media all over hyping stuff up. You don't even see me and my friends when they coming at me, when her and her friends coming at me from fake pages. You don't see people on my side even doing that, because I make sure I keep them in line with that. Like, no, it ain't that type of time. We not on that type of stuff. We not finna do that. You feel me? Like, let them do that. If I address it, it's because I'm upset about it. And, you know, I be trying not to get emotional, because that's all it really be. It be emotions involved when we respond on social media. You could have called her all the shit I hear her niggas be saying. Like, you could have called her when I'm hitting her and I'm directing it with her. Like, hey, yo, don't do this. She like, I'm doing it anyways. That's the disrespect. She did it anyways. And that's just the facts. I ain't never been in no drama. I ain't never been in no drama. So, that's what happened. And that's that.